He terrorized an Oahu neighborhood in the 1980s, raping 16 women. Today, the man known as the Manoa Rapist went before a parole board asking for a second chance. In the end, the board decided to keep him locked up. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and learned that while he won't be getting out soon, he is a step closer to being let out to work.
Joe, last month we gave the heads up this was coming. We said we'd follow up, and here's what we found out today. A work release program is being beefed up to handle John Freudenberg, and a potential federal lawsuit looms if they don't hurry. John Freudenberg raped and sodomized women in Manoa over a 14-month crime spree in the 1980s.
Being awoken by a man who's straddling them with a knife to their throat and ultimately raping them. One woman with a daughter in the room next to her.
He's been turned down for parole over and over since the 1990s, coming before the Hawaii Paroling Authority Board at Halawa Prison again Monday.
The pain that I caused to my victims, I don't want to do that again. I do not want to do that again.
The Honolulu Prosecutor's Office doesn't buy it.
The man in front of you seeking parole is essentially the same man that was out there committing these offenses back in the 80s.
The paroling authority has seen improvements and has long been in support of giving freedom a try through supervised work furlough. They rattle off the multiple times he's completed the Sex Offender Treatment Program, or SOTP.
He was in Kulani, then again at Halawa. He has 20 years of SOTP, more than any inmate. He's been ready for furlough since 1995.
The catch? Furlough isn't parole, and it's run and decided by the Department of Public Safety. They've not pulled Freudenberg out yet to try.
We're asking you to parole him because we can't get furlough.
The answer? No again, with that asterisk.
There's so much change that's occurred in 30 years that we, too, do not want to set you up for failure. We're going to deny parole, work furlough for you, and we'll see you in 11 months.
The board chair says they've talked with public safety about getting things going for the work release. The DPS director told KHON2, "We agree with the Hawaii Paroling Authority's recommendation for work furlough. He will need a carefully structured reentry plan. When the time comes, we will reevaluate him for the possibility of entering the work furlough program." We pushed for more specifics, like when will the time come? The department said they've recently brought up staffing, and now they're just trying to get the program up to speed. Freudenberg's attorney says it's not moving quickly enough.
I don't know what the solution is other than bringing a federal lawsuit regarding Mr. Freudenberg's civil rights.
We'll keep tabs on that threatened federal lawsuit. Also on the status of that work furlough, the prosecutor's office said at the hearing today they'll be fighting DPS against the work release, too. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News.